Welcome to Senior Design Project. This video is going to give you a quick overview about what the course is about, what you can expect over the next 30 weeks. So first off, I'm going to hit some of the key points for everyone taking Senior Design Project in the Mechanical Engineering Department. First off, you're focused on a design challenge. The entire Senior Design Project course sequence is going to be focused on that design challenge. You're going to have an external sponsor, someone outside of the class, and it's your goal to satisfy their needs through this process. You're going to work on a design team over the course of 30 weeks to try to solve that external sponsor's design challenge. You'll follow a design process that we walk you through, and along the way, you'll hone your professional skills. The course format consists of 3 quarters in a row, or 30 weeks of work total. You're going to use an example project. You will design, build, test, and then report out your results. You'll work on small teams and you'll have external sponsors. You will have a lab advisor that will work with you the entire course sequence. And every project is going to be different. So we're going to be focusing on the process, the design process that you follow, rather than the specifics of each of your individual projects. Let me just hit that point again. We're going to focus on the process, not the individual project. So you'll remember that design process from earlier classes. We're going to work through the whole process here. First off, defining what the problem is, then coming up with conceptual solutions, then evaluating and analyzing those solutions in order to develop a detailed design. Then you're going to manufacture a prototype, validate or test that prototype, and finally report out on the results. Throughout the process, we're going to have a number of key deliverables for you to complete. I'll go into each of these in more detail as we get closer to them, but basically, when you define the problem, you're going to produce a statement of work document that you share with your sponsor. After you've come up with a basic analysis of your concept and you've chosen a single concept to move forward with, you have a preliminary design review with your sponsor. Once you've completed all the design details, you have a critical design review with your sponsor. And then at the end, once you've completed the reporting, it goes into a final design review, which consists of a formal report as well as a design expo. There are a couple of intermediate deliverables as well. First one is an intermediate design review that sits between the preliminary and the critical design review. Then we have a manufacturing and test review where you confirm that your build is nearly complete and you give a status on your planned testing. And then a hardware demo where you show all of the final hardware ready to go for testing. We often get the question, why so structured? Why do you have this formal design process for me to follow? Well, there are a couple of good reasons for that. First off, when you're designing a complicated system, like say an automobile, you've got to coordinate between a lot of people over a long time period. It could be years for the development of that vehicle, and there could be hundreds, maybe thousands of people involved in the design. So for that level of complexity, you need a very structured process so everybody knows what's happening when and knows what deliverables to expect from different people. Now, that's bigger than what you're dealing with here, and your team is much smaller. Still a long period of time, but we want you to be prepared when you get out into your career that you will likely have some sort of structured process. So this is preparation for that. In addition, whatever project you're working on, you will have limited resources. Time is probably a major one right now. You have limited time, lots of other things going on. You need to be as efficient as possible. Make sure that each member of your team is contributing as much as they can in the areas that they're best at. Project planning is also shown to enable success of projects. If projects are well planned, they're more likely to have a successful end. And lastly, engineering practice is structured design. There's a lot of creativity within that structure, but the structure enables you to achieve success, coordinate among large groups, and be as efficient as possible. Remember, at the end of the day, this is Senior Design Project, but our focus is on the design process. Let's talk real quick about the people involved with Senior Design Project. There are a bunch of labs. In each lab, there are students, 18 students per lab, roughly. Each lab is going to have a lab advisor. Some lab advisors have more than one lab, but as far as you're concerned, you will have a lab advisor dealing with your lab. In each lab, there will be a number of projects, typically 6 in each lab, so typically about 3 students per project. Each project is going to have a sponsor. So we're dealing with lots of different sponsors, although you and your team will focus on one. There is a course organizer, that's me right now, and I work with the lab advisors and negotiate things initially with the sponsors and step in if there are any issues later on. That's a basic layout of what we're looking at. Again, in your project, you will deal primarily with your lab advisor and your sponsor, but be aware there's this whole structure out there. There's the course organizer you can come to if you're having issues with your lab advisor, or if your lab advisor needs some help dealing with a sponsor, the course organizer can help as well. Let's talk a bit more about the roles and responsibilities of each group here. So we'll start out with the project team. You're the core of the class. That's what this is all about. And your number one role and responsibility is to support your team. Help out with anything that needs to happen, make sure your team stays on track, be a good team player. You also need to attend your labs, participate in the activities in the labs. Sometimes these are directly related to your project, and sometimes they don't fit all that well because every project is different. But again, the process is our focus here, not the project itself. Then you want to make sure that you plan and track your project activities to make sure you don't miss anything along the way. Keep in contact with your sponsor. We recommend a weekly phone call with your sponsor just to let them know what's happening. Then you need to work through the design, build, and test process on your project. So first off, set an appropriate scope, work with your sponsor and your advisor to make that happen. Develop concept solutions to meet their needs. Perform all of the analysis you need in order to get a detailed design. And then work with the sponsor to get all the materials. Build your working prototype. Perform the testing of your prototype. And finally, submit all of the deliverables throughout the project. We have periodic deliverables that will help keep you on track and help you build up that final report that you have at the end of the project. How about your lab advisor? What does he or she do in the process? So she's going to help you initially to get that project scope appropriate. All of our lab advisors have a lot of experience with senior projects in the past. We know what tends to work well and what doesn't. The lab advisor will coordinate the lab activities, both the ones directly related to your project and the ones more focused on the process. He or she will also guide the teams through the design process, mediate any problems you're having with sponsors, help you find resources, and do the grading of the work that you submit. The course organizer handles things up front, finding the projects, doing an initial check for scope, but not all the details. That's up to you and your team once you get the project. Forming teams based on your interests and your skill levels will form teams. Organizing the activities that are going to happen in each of the labs. And then if issues come up, sponsor or team issues, the course organizer is also another resource for the lab advisors as well as the individual team members. And finally, the project sponsor. The role of the sponsor is to initially come up with that design challenge, to have a need that could be satisfied by some sort of mechanical system. Then they'll work with the teams to help define the project goals. What that basically means is the team owns the goals. The sponsor perhaps knows what they are and perhaps not. Perhaps they need a little help. So your role as a design team is to extract the key goals from your sponsor, perhaps ones they're not even sure of themselves. They will answer project-specific questions. Sometimes there are technical issues, and often your sponsor is going to be the technical resource for those issues. They will approve the project direction. This is why you want to keep them tied in on a weekly basis with what's going on, because when you have a major deliverable, you don't want them to say, hey, wait a minute, I didn't want you to do that, because then you got to go backtrack and restart things. They will give feedback on the deliverables. In addition to, yeah, the direction's good, they will also say, well, why don't you try this or this other thing? They will purchase the prototype materials. They are paying for the things that you're going to build, so they have to approve the amount that you're planning to spend. Again, keep them in the loop on all that. And at the end, they will give final project approval. They will hopefully thumbs up, say, yes, that's what I was looking for. Great job, team. that's the basics of the Senior Project class. And one last time, focus on the design process throughout your Senior Design Project experience. We want you to learn about that process so you can repeat it again and again as a professional engineer. This should be an exciting time. This is a fun class. There are lots of things going on. You're going to develop something from scratch, take it all the way through, build a product, and then make sure it works. Embrace that process, get to know your team, be a good team member, work with your advisor. You can make this an awesome experience, or you can make it a terrible one if you really want to. So let's make it awesome.